Well, public mourners begin filing past the coffin of Queen Elizabeth II at the Grand Westminster Hall in London. Thousands lined up overnight with a 5-kilometer queue snaking through the British capital just to be able to pay their final respects to the Queen. Some bowed or curtsied before the coffin, while some said a prayer.
I started to cry. I mean, that's part of the process of grieving, isn't it? And I didn't really expect to be so upset, but, you know, the Queen was such an icon. And
everything's still and beautiful, you know, and it's, I don't know, fantastic. I don't know, I'm just sorry, because I suppose part of it is that we've been waiting all day to do it, and then it's over in a flash, and you're past in a matter of minutes, you know, you're in and out, but it's worth it.
King Charles III, his siblings and his sons escorted the coffin from Buckingham Palace to Westminster Hall earlier in the day. Guns at Hyde Park were fired at the chimes of Big Ben tolled during the procession. The royal family then held a 20-minute service led by the Archbishop of Canterbury in Westminster before the doors were opened to the public. Westminster Hall will be open 24 hours a day until the Queen's funeral on Monday, September 19. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky has been involved in a car accident. A passenger car collided with a presidential vehicle in Kyiv, but a spokesperson says Zelensky was not injured. The Ukrainian president was on his way back to Kyiv after visiting the city of Izium, which was recently recaptured from Russian troops. There, he thanked troops who took part in the swift counteroffensive against Russian occupiers. On Wednesday, Zelensky said his troops have retaken at least 8,000 square kilometers of territory from Moscow. Over in China, Typhoon Muifa makes landfall for a second time on the east coast. All flights were grounded at Shanghai's two international airports as the storm hit land. It is packing winds of up to 120 kilometers per hour. Muifa previously hit the city of Zhaoshan in the Zhejiang province. China's weather agency has issued its highest-level typhoon alert for the first time this year. Powerful winds and heavy rains are in the forecast along China's eastern seaboard until Thursday morning. Muifa is the 12th typhoon to hit China this year. U.S. senators taking the first step to direct military aid to Taiwan amid heightened tensions with China. The U.S. Senate Foreign Relations Committee on Wednesday approved the Taiwan Policy Act, which seeks to provide $4.5 billion in security assistance over 4 years to the self-ruled island. It also lays out sanctions on China if it uses force to try to seize Taiwan. This marks an upgrade in the relationship of the two nations, as Taipei had only previously bought weapons from Washington. The committee's chairman clarifies the U.S. is not seeking war or increased tensions with China, but only leveling the playing field in case Beijing makes a move on Taiwan. Worries for Taiwan escalated following a visit to Taipei by House Speaker Nancy Pelosi and other lawmakers, which had prompted China to stage major war games around the island. 3 out of 10 Filipinos surveyed during the last days of the Duterte administration in June said their quality of life had worsened compared to last year. 31% of adult respondents said their life became worse. 29% said their life got better, while 39% said it did not change over the past year. The poll results show almost the same numbers as the one conducted in April. The SWS also said, according to its June survey, it's 11.6% of Filipino families, or an estimated 2.9 million people, experienced involuntary hunger at least once in the past 3 months.